they've done over the last 28 games where they've gone 17-11. And build on that and start to play some very good baseball. Now, I usually don't mention this, usually don't say this. They usually just leave and don't make any statements, but I will tell you that we won't be here tomorrow. We'll be back next week for a full week of shows. We won't be here tomorrow or Friday, but we will be here. We're back for a full week of shows on Monday. So, yeah, next week we will be in all week with a lot going on and a lot to do. So we will do that on Monday. So back then. So, and I also want to thank all the folks the last couple days. In a row is tough. And when you do five remotes in a row at three different destinations and you got stuff going on from all the way from the Javits Center to Citi Field to out here, Bethpage Black, you know, it taxes people. Plus, throw in 95 degrees every day, and obviously it's taxed the crew both from my radio and TV standpoint. So thank everybody for their hard work. You know, it's time for them to all go and jump in a pool somewhere because it's that kind of day. It's been, you know, just crazy hot out here today. But we thank everybody for the hospitality and, like I said, we've come five remotes in 5 days in three different spots. So we've kind of been all over the place. And I thought, you know, looking back over the All-Star the weekend, starting with the Javits, I thought baseball did well. I thought the city did well. I thought they did well in Citi Field. I thought they did well in the Javits Center. I thought they put forth a good show. And the All-Star game itself wasn't overly exciting. I mean, yeah, that was the case. But I thought the fan fest was lively. I thought the crowd was very big. I thought it was well attended. I thought there were a lot of kids there. I thought Oakland Derby was lively and really did a very good job. I think that the tribute to Rivera was very touching last night. There wasn't very many moments in that game, but the Rivera one is one that will live on. That obviously Harvey's first inning when he got out of the jam, as he did, and so that was impressive there. But it was a good couple of days for the city here, and you know, we are only 200 days away, and when we get finally through the summer, we get through July and August and get back into Labor Day, the countdown will be at about 175 days, and it will begin in earnest for the Super Bowl. And you will see it after Labor Day everywhere. You will see countdown clocks. You will see countdown clocks on both sides of the Hudson. You will see really so many reminders on a daily basis that we are on a countdown to the Super Bowl. And that event, now that we have put the All-Star game away, the All-Star game, it will be an appetizer compared to what the Super Bowl will be here. That event will be unbelievable in Jersey, in New York, and especially here in Manhattan. It will be an unbelievable situation, and we are now inside 200 days of counting for the Super Bowl. And like I said, that will be this fall. It will be a daily reminder. I mean, you will see countdown. You will not get away from it no matter where you go. You will understand and be reminded that we are on a countdown to the Super Bowl. And that 175 days will go fast, as we are not that far away. By the time we come back, we'll start talking about visiting Giant Camp. Remember, the Giants will be home this year, not in Albany. Visiting, we may even pay a visit. How about this? We may pay a visit to the Jets. Maybe. Not done yet, but maybe. It's possible. We have a little conversation going on, so it's not out of the realm of possibility.
Jesus!
We don't know until it happens. But that's the case. So we thank everybody here. When we come back after we do the update, you will hear from Mike Davis, and we'll see you in a couple days.
You remember the days you could smoke on an airplane? Now you can't even smoke in a bar. I mean, really, that's what bars were for. And that's ridiculous. Bunch of crybabies made the rules, and now we're suffering. But then came along Finn electronic cigarettes. It's just vapor, and you can smoke them virtually anywhere. It's about time us smokers can tell them non-smokers where to stick it. Take your life back. Finn electronic cigarettes. Pick them up at your local convenience store.
Stronger than a storm.com. I'm on a ferry to go to New York Harbor, so you're
window. One day, her shoe was suddenly struck by lightning, and all her belongings got burnt to a jar. Luckily, the Geico Insurance Agency recently helped her with condo insurance. She got all her belongings replaced. She now has a rubber sole on her condo, and it's fully grounded. Call Geico and see how easy it is to switch and save on condo insurance.
Offers 5,000 off deal and posted price excludes 2014 Kia Forte 36-month lease with your 5,000 due at inception and tax and rent fees.
All right, you mugs. Gateway Kia is grabbing all our customers, so we need some good ideas to get it back. Any thoughts, Mugsy?
Why don't we save them 5,000 on a new Kia like Gateway Kia does?
What? We'll never beat Gateway Kia. But I love the idea.
Others may try, but no one saves you money like Gateway Kia in North Brunswick, where everyone gets 5,000 over one for your dream or 5,000 in incentives. Or put a check in your pocket for 5 grand with 2013 Kia Optima LXs for just $159 a month. Only Gateway Kia gives you 5,000 over one for your dream or 5,000 in incentives from the dealer posted price. Or buy or lease any new Kia and get a check for 5 grand. We'll see you at Gateway Kia in North Brunswick on Route 1 and our new store on Route 10 in Denville, New Jersey.
Ready to go on the fan. Mike's on.
Mike's on. Okay, man, one of the wholesome things about him
right now. He has also been the center of a lot of tension this year. But he is a terrific you as we welcome Ike. And I don't know how you went along to the show today, first of all, Ike. I mean, I know you're an actor, but you're out of your mind. Anyway, you're from the place where it's honored every day, but I mean, it is more center. Even it's got to be for you, Ethan, right?
Yeah, well,
you're
honored.
But you go back inside. Welcome. How you doing? All right, Ike. How are things? I mean, we spent a lot of the year with fans. Every question I've had all year to Sandy or to Terry, a lot of it's been about you. How do you feel about things since you come back?
Better. Obviously, played a little better. Seeing the ball a little longer and instead of jumping at the ball, kind of, recognizing it a little better. But obviously, still need to get better and work on the
You and I share one thing. We make all mistakes in public. I mean, that's one thing. And that's at least with different life. Go through this. You've gone through a lot here this year. It's been day after day. It's had a wear on you. It really has.
Yeah, I mean, it's not easy to be doing horrible especially in New York, when people care so much about their sports and things like that. But, there's good fans out there, and there's obviously the bad ones, but just how they yell here for no reason sometimes.
I think they want to love you, but they want to have expectations, And plus, you're a very perplexing case. You had 32 home runs last year. You knocked in 90 runs in basically two-thirds of a season. I mean, you put up your number one sluggers in isolated power in baseball the last 3 months last year. You showed you can do this.
Yeah, it's definitely frustrating, for sure. It's so weird. I had a great spring, and then came in and
opening day was a bad day. I wonder, opening day you had a rough day. I wonder if opening day spun you into something. Because you had a bad opening day. I remember that. And I said, well, I had a bad opening day. I think it's one game. You never really got out of that.
No, it was weird.
Because you hit the ball well in the spring, right?
I felt great. Then, opening day, it didn't do well. Then, I hit a home run the next day. And it was like, okay, good. I'm back. But,
let me not ask you how you feel. Let me ask you, do you sense that the organization has lost faith in you at all, or have they not given you that indication?
Not really. Obviously, they called me back up and haven't discarded me totally yet.
Right. But, I mean, even that, you were like, last year, every day, in the lineup, bat in ability order, cool, Mike's a power hitter, Mike's this. You were part of the franchise. You were a core guy on this team. And I still think they think you are. I get the idea that, they still believe. I get the idea from talking to these guys that they still believe
when
you.
When I'm right, I can be very, very good.
Sure. And you're a good fielder, too. Yeah. So, you give them that too.
Just, I haven't played well this year. And,
are you relaxed? Is it a relaxation thing? Do you get uptight now because things haven't gone well? And do you sense that as part of it? I mean, I'm sure you've examined this from every possible way.
Sure. Sometimes, especially on a bad streak,
right?
Something like I've had. But, the key is staying loose and just being confident and trusting in your ability to play the game.
It's a funny thing, Ike, because you can sense that the Mets are kind of turning the corner now. The pitchers are coming, the team is starting to play a little better, and a lot of the stuff we discussed, like yesterday when I had Sandy on at City Field, who's going forward as part of this franchise as we move forward.